Do you believe that impeachment, forget about principle, from a pragmatic perspective, is it worth the time and energy? Does it leave us in a better place?
I think as a country, it's worth it because the Constitution calls for it. It's just one of those moments where you got to set aside the politics. I don't know what the political effects are going to be. I don't think we should pay attention to that. I mean, obviously, as a candidate for office, I'm going to deal with the environment that we're in. And it is an issue that's on voters' minds. But the biggest thing I'm being asked about is the question I think every voter at the end of the day asks is, how's my life going to be different?
You saw that a guy like Lieutenant Colonel Vindman, okay, he has the kind of pedigree you almost can't make up in terms of how much duty to service there has been. And he got attacked. Bill Taylor, the diplomat who has so many years in, who was asked to come in and do this job, he gets attacked. In the back of your mind, do you think, I don't even know what I'm getting into yet. This game is about bleeding and who bleeds out first. I know that sounds completely dramatic, but it's the reality as well. How do you handle that?
You know, I was a 22-year-old campaign staffer, my very first job, working on the Kerry campaign out in Arizona, when an envelope came in to our campaign office with a Purple Heart and a cutout of a Purple Heart and a Band-Aid stuck to it. This is nothing new, although they've definitely taken it to new depths. But we've seen this for some time, denigrating the service of war heroes, scraping the absolute bottom of the barrel when it comes to the way that those in power right now treat anybody who gets in their way, even a decorated veteran like Colonel Vindman. And I think it's all the more evidence of why things need to change. But I'll say this too, there comes a point where this is just unsustainable, just like that moment in the McCarthy hearings where someone said, have you no sense of decency? And because I believe deep down there are Republican senators and Congress members, just as there are so many millions of Republican voters who know that this is dead wrong, that sooner or later, as long as we're doing the right thing, we will get to the other side of this. And in the meantime, my job is to make sure that this isn't even close. In other words, as a candidate for president, the best thing that could happen to defeat not just Trump, but Trumpism, is to make sure that we build such a strong coalition, such a big majority, that there is such a thumping in November of 2020 against Trumpism and everything associated with it, that it creates the shockwaves required to reunite Republicans in elected office with their conscience or lead to the dissolution and reinvention of that party.
You know, when they show national polls, all of you guys beat the president. But when they did the state-by-state polls recently, he is strong and long in almost every state that matters. I mean, just Michigan alone. You know, the Democrats keep talking about turning that back blue. They got a lot of work to do. What was the message for you in that?
Well, it's that we got to go out there and do the work. And, you know, Michigan is literally, I'm not going to say it, I can see it from my porch, but it's maybe 10 minutes from my house. This is my part of the country, a lot of these states. And what we've got to do is make sure that we're making the case. I just spent the last few days in Iowa in largely conservative communities, rural areas that are ready for a different message. But you got to show up. You got to bring that message to people where they are.
You talk a lot about respect. Respect these competitors, even if they come at you and they say things. Do you respect President Trump?
I mean, I respect the office of the presidency.
The second part is what I'm talking about.
He has done nothing to command my respect. I'll say that.
Why?
Because he doesn't respect his own presidency. And frankly, at a deeper level, I don't think he respects himself. I think he has created a sort of cartoon character, which is fine if you're a reality TV star, where you're playing a part, even when the part is yourself. When you're the president of the United States, lives depend on your integrity, on your wisdom, on your judgment, and I just don't see it in this White House.
And in the man, you don't see it?
I don't see any integrity there. I mean, you look at him and there's just a sense that he would do anything. This is a guy who's shown no evidence of any principle other than that of advancing himself. And that is so costly right now, especially now that he's actually got this level of power. And we're seeing the consequences at home, where, by the way, he's also not been able to deliver on any of the things that he set out to do or promise. The only promise he's managed to keep is a tax cut for the enormously wealthy. That and some conservative judicial appointments. The rest, none of it's happening. Manufacturing workers are actually finding themselves worse off. He's not building the wall. He's never going to build the wall. And the party did build. They're sawing through. I mean, none of the things he said he was going to do are happening. And moreover, I don't think any of the things he said he was going to do are things he actually cares about.
Mayor Pete, thank you very much. I appreciate it. Good luck going forward. We'll talk to you again.
Good to be with you.